Hello everyone, welcome back to another Adobe Photoshop CC tutorial. This one, I'm going to show you how to darken an image, or you know, an image that you've taken a shot of, or you're using and it's overexposed, or it's too bright basically. I'm going to show you a couple ways to fix it. One of them's really, really quick, and not a lot of people know this one, and then the second one is using tools and stuff like that. So let's just get right into this. I have an image here that is too bright. It's a little overexposed, as you can tell here. And I want to just sort of darken it up and get some of the darks to come out and take a little bit off the light. So the first thing you can try, and this isn't a perfect method, but it's very, very quick if time is an issue. You take your layer here, you take your image, drag and drop it on top of the old make another duplicate layer here. So you've got two layers, and then the top layer that you've got selected, take the blend mode and change it to multiply. Right here, this might be what you're looking for. This might be good enough, and it does a pretty good job. It's not perfect. I mean, you could always go ahead and make adjustments and things like that, which we will do, but just keep in mind that if you want to fix an image that's too bright and you don't want to go all the way through the histogram and all the dials, etc., that might just do the trick right there. All right, let's get rid of that layer anyway. I'm going to show you a second set. The next one that you would want to work with is the levels, and I'm going to left-click on this. And then you're going to see here that we've got some pretty bright stuff going on here, and it's kind of pushed to the right. If I go to Window, and then I go to Histogram, when you look at the histogram, you'll see that everything's kind of stacked up on the right side here. So we want to get rid of that. So let's just go right back into Levels, and I'm just going to double-click on it here. And then the first thing, I am going to lay off the whites a bit, so let's just reduce that white output level down to, say, there. The second thing, I'm gonna go ahead and make some adjustments with this little slider here. So I'm gonna add in some more midtones here, a little bit more shadows. I'm gonna back off this a little bit. Let's see how much, not too much actually. Let's go to right about there. And then maybe we'll darken this a bit more because it is pretty dark. And maybe something like that compared to, like, if we take the effect on or off. Off, poof, that's pretty bright. Effect on, that's a lot better right there, guys. There are other things you can do. You can always look at brightness and contrast. So it's pretty bright, so you can darken it a smidgen here. This is looking good. I would probably increase the contrast just a little bit, maybe 5 or 6. And then let's look at that. So let's take that off. So that's the original. That's a bit of adjustments with levels. That's a slight adjustments with brightness and contrast. And guys, these are the types of things that you can do. Vibrance, let's go all the way up, all the way down. It's not really one that I would use on this one. Maybe add a little bit of vibrance into it, just because I like the coloring. And leave the saturation alone. We could desaturate it if you want to go for that old school look. But those are the types of things that you can do to go ahead and really just fix an image that is too bright in like 1 or 2 minutes, guys. The other one, again, is if we put that layer and we double up and then we make that into multiply like we did in the beginning there. Boom. Okay, that's a little over the top, right? But I mean, maybe we add in, we get rid of that, we get rid of that, and maybe that's the look you're going for. I'm not sure, guys, but that's how you do it. That's how you change it inside Photoshop. You can also do it inside Camera Raw, and I'm going to show you how to do that in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching.